All right, we're going to do a review. LoneStarGrills.com. This is my new smoker. I'll give you a little overview of it here. Got a bulldog style hitch. A swivel jack with a wheel on it. Got a couple of propane bottles here. It's a high propane, high pressure propane burner. But now we got some beans going on there. We'll take a peek here in a minute of the beans. Step back here on the other side. Pretty cool idea we came up with Chris. This is a Dutch oven table, so I can make cobbler. I make peach cobbler. It's pretty much all I like to make for dessert, so that suits it real well. Gonna get the job done. Got a little area here in the front that has proven to be priceless today. This is my first cook on this grill. Oh, here we got a hook for a dinner bell. I haven't gotten one yet, so I'm just using it for my Dutch oven lid lifter today. Here's a smokestack. See, it's going pretty well. That just switches here at the bottom. It opens and closes. I like that design really well. It's one of the better ones I've seen. Around the side here, we got, this is the cook chamber. Cook chamber on this one is a 24 by 48. It's quarter inch steel, got flange doors. Very, very, very minimal smoke coming out from behind the doors. We'll take a look inside. See, we got four grates. Those are just some empty pans. I got my juice from my pork butt and my brisket. We'll switch sides. I got some venison sausage going and some ribs. Got some chicken going with some suckle busters on it. My thermometers I upgraded to are from barbecuebonanza.com. They're calibratable. They got a set screw on the back so you know that they're exactly right. I'll just calibrate them in boiling water. As we get towards the back of the trailer here, see the lid on the firebox. It's an adjustable grill. Two-level grill that you can grill on if you're not smoking. You can't do both at the same time. It's got the opening damper there on the side. All of the handles are cool touch spring handles. Got a 3x5 box here that's got a divider in it. This side we use for wood. The other side I use for a cooler and for my chairs. And you can see the little yellow handle down there. That's a quarter inch, inch and a quarter brass ball valve. And this water will hold, this pit will hold water in the bottom of it. And then when you get done, you just open that up and it drains right out, makes for a real nice clean out. Some of the features of Chris's pits. LED lights. Right now he's got a special going. You get 15 inch chrome wheels with the purchase of your grill. That's the on-off valve. There's a propane burner in the firebox, propane log starter that works really well. Doesn't take much to get you a fire started in this pit. You got side marker lamps, LED also. This is a turn-off valve for the high-pressure burner. Here's my discada that I can use on the burner too. This thing's like a rolling kitchen. There's nothing that that I can't do on this. I'll give you a shot of my beans. If you want my bean recipe, there's bacon, beans, water, and spices in there. In this cooler right now, I got my pork butt and my brisket done. Cook time was pretty quick on those today, so they're already done, just sitting there in a cooler and towels, waiting for folks to get here. This is Easter Sunday, 2011. We'll take a look in the peach cobbler here. Just got it going, getting towards the end of the cook here, so, oh yeah, that's some peach cobbler from scratch. Best daggum stuff you ever eat in your life. We'll go ahead and let that keep on cooking. So all in all, a very, very versatile grill. Also on the bottom of this, I forgot to mention, there's Chris puts tuning plates in here. There's this particular grill has four tuning plates, and they're on angle iron, so you just move them back and forth till you get them set like you want them. There's not a locking feature on them yet to lock them in place, but I'm gonna get with Chris about that and see see if he has any ideas of what to do to make them locking so I can change that. That's the only thing that I would do different on this pit. Everything else is perfect. It's a really, really nice pit. Cooks really well. This being the first time, man, I have no complaints on it. This thing just fired up this morning, and I seasoned it yesterday with a couple of cans of spray-on vegetable oil, and come out this morning and started cooking. My meat was so tender, I had to use a fish grilling spatula to pull it up because it kept trying to break in half. So it did its job there. We'll show you the inside of the firebox here. Kind of smoky, but you can see it's got a fire grate on the bottom of it. Got my wood going there. I'm smoking with mesquite today. And your entertainment today is furnished courtesy of coolcoolers.com, my Texas Tech Red Raider cooler. Say hi, partner. Can you say hi? Sit. You'll sit down? Sit down. Say hi, party. This is partner. He's my partner in the Black Pug. Anyway, the music is provided courtesy of Cool Coolers. Find them on Facebook. Find them on YouTube. Just plug an iPod into that baby and a little lawnmower battery, and off it goes. So, anyway, if you have any questions, you can post them back to me on my YouTube page, and I'll be glad to get back and answer any of that I can. Again, that's LoneStarGrillsWithAZ.com.